يفنى الكل ويبقى هو، ليس الباقي إلا هو. الله 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 الله، ما لي رب إلا هو.
Muslim Ummah and the entire world is facing one of the most daunting and most difficult times in many, many years and in almost a century, where we are faced with an illness and with a pandemic, a waba, which is eating through communities throughout the world, from the east to the west. There is fear, there is panic, and people are looking for solutions. And in reality, the solution to every problem and to all calamities and all disasters are with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. اور جو اللہ سے ڈرے اللہ اس کے لیے نجات کی راہ نکال دے گا. And for whom who fears Allah, Allah will open for him a path of rescue. Allah will grant him a path of salvation. Allah will grant him a path of exit from which he may exit this calamity that he's facing. And if we look at the tafsir of this, one of the tafsirs of this verse of the Holy Quran, it is mentioned in the tafsir that if one fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because time and over you hear and you read in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah. O believers, fear Allah. Fear Allah, fear Allah. So the books of tafsir are referring to the same when discussing this verse, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And for whom who fears Allah, Allah will open for him a path of rescue. Allah will give him a path of rescue. The tafsir book says that if one fears Allah, Almighty Allah will remove all his calamities and protect him. Allah will remove his calamities and protect him, no matter what the calamity is, no matter how much of taklif he is in. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said regarding this verse of the Holy Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. The beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever recites and reads this verse, he will be given deliverance and a path out of difficulties when facing the misgivings of this dunya and the fear of death. And he will have safety from the day of Qiyamah, on the day of Qiyamah. And our Akhay Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I know such a verse that if people preserve it, then it is sufficient for all their needs and matters. And this is the verse that the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Why this verse? Every verse is blessed, but the beloved Rasul is telling you that if you want exit, if you want rescue, if you want safety, then you have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above everything. You have to fear Allah above illnesses. You have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above diseases. You have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above the plague. You have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above every waba and above every pandemic. And when you do that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy will descend. And bear in mind that there are numerous discussions regarding this here. Allah says in the Holy Quran, in the same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَزْبُهُ. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَزْبُهُ. اور جو اللہ پر بھروسہ کرے تو وہ اسے کافی ہے. And whomsoever puts his trust in Almighty Allah, then Allah is sufficient for him. Allah is sufficient for him. What do we need to do in times like this? Yes, we have to take precautions. There is no doubt. The medical fraternity is giving us precautions. The governments of the world are giving us precautions. We have to adhere to precautions. If we do not, we are foolish. We have to take the precautions. But remember, those precautions which are within the boundaries of the Shariat Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those that do not transgress the hukum of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because if we do that which transgresses intentionally, then what are we doing? We are losing our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People say, tie your camel. Tie your camel. Whatever we are doing, some things we are doing that you think we shouldn't do, or people think we shouldn't do, we are doing this to tie your camel. Tie your camel. We are not saying cut the legs off your camel. Huh? Tying the camel means you put trust in Allah and do what Allah commands you to do. That is tying your camel. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the faisla who will live and who will die. This is the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Quran is saying, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَزْبُهُ. Okay, and whomsoever puts his trust in Almighty Allah. In other words, do what you need to do, but put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah is sufficient for you. I'm giving you the example of our own country. I understand that you have to keep yourself clean and hygienic and park. That is the zimidari of every Muslim all the time in your life. Nobody has taught hygiene better than Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nobody has taught deen and purification in any community more than Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I understand that we have to keep our hands clean. I understand that we should not, do not sneeze on people, do not cough. This is what Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said 1400 years ago. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us this 1400 years ago. These are the precautions. The Nabi has told us, that which the Nabi told us are precautions, today people are telling us that this is the precaution. Yes, we accept it, because our Nabi also said the same thing. But at the same time, you must understand that you cannot just leave the houses of Allah abandoned. This is a very sad state of affairs, and I'm saying this. Many may not like what I say. There may be many who would speak against what I'm saying right now. I know that everybody has a different thought and different view on certain things. But I'm telling you what is the dard and the feeling of the heart, the sadness of the heart. And you look at the world over. I'm giving our own country, our government and the president of South Africa has announced that there should be gatherings no more than 100. Should try and keep it controlled. It's an understandable announcement. It's something that makes sense to avoid this thing to go out of control. It is what they have been taught and explained by the medical fraternity and by their experiences. They are telling us something which is understandable, and I understand it, and we do not go against that. That you should now go and make big 1,000 people mahfils and say, right, don't care about what is being said in the country. No, you have to take heed to it. But I want to say something, that the sad part about it is the masjids have been closed. Many masajid have been closed the night that the announcement was made. Masjids closed for 2 weeks and 3 weeks and 4 weeks in a row, prematurely. Immediately masajids closed, there will be no five times salah, there will be no Jummah. I want to ask a question. How many masajid, let's be honest, how many masajid just in our country are there that get 100 people on a normal salah? How many are there? Count how many are there that get 100 people for Fajr salah, 100 people for Dhuhr, Asr, Asr, or Maghrib, or Isha? How many are there? Very few that get 100. Even there can be intizam made. Okay, but the government is saying we are allowing you 100. For any reason, 100, not just masjid, any gathering shouldn't exceed 100. But we are saying don't even keep the 100. Don't even do 75. Just shut it down. Shut it down, because this vile, we don't want anybody to say that we spread this. This is not spread by anybody, this is by the will of Allah. We are going to take the necessary precautions. We are not saying transgress the precautions. But masjids are closed. Jamaat five times a day stopped for weeks. For what? In fear of possibility that we may spread this virus to one another. We want to avert a disaster, hence we closed the house of Allah beforehand. Is the disaster confirmed? Is it confirmed that it will happen like we all think? Like we all assume? I want to ask a question. Are factories closed, in which there are more than 100 workers that sit together where there are machinists sewing clothes that are close to each other, that they are interacting with each other all the time in factories? Are factories closed? Those who are closing the masajid, you have your own view, but we want to ask, the heart is asking questions, that those donors and sponsors that support our masajid and our organizations, have we asked them to shut their factories down? Have we asked them to immediately shut their businesses and their shops and their takeaways? Because if there are more than so many people entering their shops, that they will be infected? That they will become infected by this virus? Are we asking them to close? Look, if the government enforces that there will be a total lockdown, we will try to request what is best. But if they put a lockdown and they say that everything has to shut down, then we are living in the Darul Harb, we have no control over this. But right now, we have a control. We have some kind of flexibility. The courts have closed their doors in our country, but now they have opened again. Even the courts have been opened, and a maximum of 100 people have been re-allowed. They have been allowed. And we are shutting the doors to the house of Allah and holding back people from falling into sajda in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because when they're going to come for namaz, what if one person has got it? But what if one person has got it in the shopping center? But what if one person has got it at workplace? What if? And we're talking about cleanliness and purity, Allahu Akbar, and purification. What does Allah say in the Holy Quran? What do you do when you go in the masjid? What are we doing? We are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we are reading the Quran. When we go to the masjid, the Quran is being recited. What does Allah say? وَنَّزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we reveal in the Quran that which is shifa and mercy for those with iman. Or humne Quran, or hum Quran mein utarte hai wo cheez jo iman walon ke liye shifa aur rahmat hai. What are we doing in salah? We are praying namaz. What Allah is saying? Kul huwa lilladhina amanu huda wa shifa. Aur tum farmao ae habub, iman walon ke liye hidayat aur shifa. You say the Quran, it is guidance and shifa for the believers. Look at the tafsir of these verses. In other words, the Quran shows the path of guidance, saves us from deviance, and it cures us from sickness of the hearts and ignorance and having uncertainties. And when it is recited, the Mufassirin have stated that the Quran is shifa for all our physical illnesses. We know that after iman and refinement of one's beliefs, as per the true tenets of Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat, namaz is regarded the most essential and exalted fard, the obligatory fard of all faraid actions. But read, yes, we can read in our homes, but the point is that why are we not afraid that we will be infected anywhere else? Why just the masjid? Why the house of Allah? I'm not saying transgress more than 100 people. Try at least to do that. And we're talking about purification and cleanliness and tahara. It is reported in Sahih Muslim from Hadrat Abu Hurairah radiallahu anh that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a person performs tahara, ghusl and wudu, etc. at his home, and then walks towards the masjid to fulfill his fard, then one sin is washed away on every step, and on the next step his status is elevated one fold. What does Allah say in the Holy Quran about the masajid? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, إِنَّمَا يَعْمَرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَعَسَ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنْ يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ. And only, Allah says in the Holy Quran, only they fill and populate the mosques who believe in Allah and in the last day, and who establish namaz and give zakat, and who fear none but Allah. Verily, they are of those who will find the path. They are of those who will be on the path of guidance. Look at what the Quran is saying. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. I'm understanding the preventative part of it. But when we are being allowed to do this, to go and make ibadat, why are we shutting it down completely? Why are we doing this? There are places that people are even stopping the adhan. Do not even want to give the adhan in some places. Allahu Akbar. Yet the fuqaha have said, and I'm quoting to you what the fuqaha say. The fuqaha say it is mustahab to proclaim the azan in the ear of a newborn child, in the ear of a grief-pierced person, in the ear of one who is having an epileptic seizure, one who is overwhelmed by anger, in the ear of an intempered person or animal, during the intensity of a battle, when a fire is raging, and when burying a deceased, when a jinn is displaying his mischief, behind a traveler, and when those of you who lose your way in the jungle, in an isolated and harsh environment, and there is no guide to you, and it is also mustahab to proclaim the azan during any plague or disaster or pandemic. Look at Raddul Mukhtar, look at Fatawa Radwiya Sharif. Those of us who are saying that we are Ahlul Sunnah wal Jamaat, what has been mentioned? It is mentioned in the hadith of Abu Dawud and Ibn Hibban, which is reported from Hadrat Abu Umama radiallahu anh, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are three types of persons who are in the divine care of Allah. They are in the divine care of Allah, they are in the dhiman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That if they are alive, he blesses them with sustenance which is sufficient. And if they die, he will enter them into Jannah. Who are those three persons? That person who on entering his home conveys salam to those in his house is in the divine care of Allah. That person who goes to the masjid is in the divine care of Allah. And one who goes out in the way of Allah is in the divine care of Allah. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Look at what is being said to us by our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And what is mentioned? It is in Sahih Muslim Sharif, narrated from Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. What did the beloved Rasul say? Our Nabi said, the most beloved to Allah than all places in the dunya is the masjid, are the masajid, and the places most disliked are the marketplaces. Nabi said, the most beloved is the masjid, the most disliked are the marketplaces. We are not stopping the people from opening their businesses. We are not stopping those of us who are closing the masjid. We are not stopping people from opening their stores. We are not stopping people from opening their factories. We are not saying to them that don't open your factory this month and don't give us whatever donations you give for the next 6 months because you have to keep your mask. We have to you have to keep your business closed. We know it will cause you nuksan. Do not do any of these things. Leave all, close everything, shut everything down. We are not saying close that and stop that which the Nabi said the marketplaces are the worst of places. We are saying close that place with Allah's Nabi said is the best of places. We are saying close the house of Allah. None is worried about going about the marketplace and strictly asking people to stop going to the markets. Okay? They are saying, okay, better if you don't go to the mall. Better if you stay at home. Take care. If you don't need to go, don't go. Because it is being said in the Hadith Sharif, not to go into the market without reason is to take the flag of Shaitan. That we know. To take the banner of Shaitan and go. Look at the condition. We are saying close the wudu khanas. Again, I understand the hygiene part of it. Close the wudu khanas. But think about it. You go to the airports, go to the airports now, go to public places, the urinals where they stand and make peshab open. People need to go to the toilet. Go and look at the airports, go and look at certain places, the urinals where people stand and urinate are open, public toilets are open, the wudu khanas are closed. What happens in the wudu khana? People may wash and clean themselves. They say, no, but Maulana, they can those urinals and those toilets are disinfected. Can we not disinfect the wudu khana area, the gutter areas, where the waters are flowing? Yes, we know it is better to make wudu at home. It is more sawab. But no one is saying close down the urinals where people stand and make peshab. But the wudu khana is being closed down. Our people are saying, as I said, you can disinfect those. Can you not disinfect these? Are we trying to tell? What is the message that the Muslim Ummah is passing by doing this? Are we trying to tell the world that the masjid is so filthy and the masjid environment is so impure and Muslims are so unhygienic that if we close the masjid, you will be safe? If people go to pray salah, they will cause bimari or they will get sick. Is the masjid a germ factory? The masjid removes germs. The masjid removes bacteria. We don't say, don't go to masjid. Huh? We say, sorry, we are saying, go to masjid, don't go to masjid. People are saying, don't go to masjid. Don't go to masjid. Close it just in case infected people come, they will infect all. Why aren't we saying, don't go to work, as I said earlier? Huh? Today, people are going to stockpile. People are going to the supermarkets. This stockpiling and hoarding is not allowed in Shariat Mustafa. Get what is your necessity. Do not cause taklif to others in times like this. Make it easy for everybody in times like this. Okay? But I want to ask a question. I'm also going to the store, supermarket. I need to get stuff for my home also. You need to get for your home also. When you go into a store, and currently when the queues are in the stores right now, because of the stockpiling situation, for how long are you standing in the supermarket store? I want to ask, for how long are you standing in the queue? How many people are you standing with in a queue at the supermarket and for how long? If you are person number 10, how close are you standing to the 9 that are in front of you? Sometimes 10 minutes, sometimes 15 minutes. Did you not think that if one of those who has the virus, or if the one standing right in front of me, or the one directly behind me has the virus, or the one at the side has the virus, then I too will have the virus? So let me not shop anymore. Let me not go to the bank. Let me not do any of these things anymore. Let me completely stop. But now let us go close the masjid. And not let the people come to pray as they are standing next to us and they're standing behind us and they're standing in front of us. You may stand in those queues for 15 and 20 minutes. How long does it take for one 2 rakat jamaat namaz? How long does it take for one 4 rakat jamaat namaz? And that too you are in the hook in the divine mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloveds, think for a moment. What are we doing? What are we doing? Think. Do you know what the announcement of the government is? 100. I'm going back to it. Now I'm talking about our country for now. 100. 100. Keep it up to 100. Don't go more than that. Okay? If you can have less, the better. Yes, but keep it to 100. We are being allowed that there. But you know what they are saying with that 100 as well? They are saying the government has announced, and it's clear, that the bars and the shebeens can open. The places where people are drinking alcohol and half of them are in a state of intoxication, they are even allowing that up to 50 people. The only rule has been they must be closed at 6 p.m. They must be closed at 6 p.m. Now think about it. People in bars are drinking sharab and alcohol. When they are drinking, are they in the normal state? But they are allowed. If the government felt that this was completely detrimental in their eyes, they would have stopped that also. But they are not stopping that. And those who are keeping it open are keeping it open. They have been told, space people apart, etc. Haram place, haram kaam ho raha hai. All this is happening. Those places are open, but you want to shut the house of Allah where maybe 5 musallis will come for Fajr, and 10 musallis will come for Zuhr, and 15 musallis will come for Isha. What is happening? What is happening? Huh? I read one of my ulama friends sent me a message of a narration of Muhammad bin Abdul Rahman al-Qurayshi. He says in 764 Hijri, when faced by plague in Egypt, people prayed, they kept fast, they gave sadqah, they repented. They did all of these things. He said, do you know what we did? We took our wives and our children and we went and sought refuge in the house of Allah, and we were blessed with benefit during that plague. And they were saved at that time. People are saying that this is, we can't just say this is azab. We can't say what this is. Did Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam not say that plague is a rahmah to a believer? If he dies in it, he is a shaheed. We shout out the nara of Mawla Ali and the nara of Haydari. We say Ali Mushkil Kusha. Would Mawla Ali have closed the masjid if he were here today? Would Hadrat Ghawse Pak radiallahu anhu have done what we are doing? Would Sarkare Khaja Muinuddin Chishti Ajmeri Sanjari Sultan ul Hind, would my Khaja have done this today? Would my Ala Hadrat have done this today? Let's think about it for a moment. What did our Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say? Nabi said, At-tuhuru shatrul iman. Coming back to purification. Purification and cleanliness is the branch of your iman. It is half your iman. Huh? Your purification and cleanliness. You make wudu 5 times a day and come to the masjid to make salah. Will a person carry the virus or will be coming, cleaning everything and coming by making wudu? Huh? What did the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? We forgot our basics. Hadhrat Abu Huraira reports that Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, tell me, if someone has a river outside or a stream outside his door and he bathes in it 5 times a day, will there be any dirt left in his body? The Sahaba Ikram said, no. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, this is the very example of the 5 daily salah. Almighty Allah removes one's sins due to this. So Allah removes the bimari due to this, and Allah the sins due to this. Indeed, the Rabb who can remove sins will remove your bimaris. He will remove our illnesses. So that wuzu removes sins. And it removed the bimari also with Allah's will. By Allah, if we are sincere in the court of Allah and take the necessary precautions. I'm not saying do not take precautions. I'm not saying do not take medical precautions. The wudu, but if we do this sincerely and put our trust in Allah, وَمَا يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And we have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by Allah, the wudu will remove all that which no sanitizer and no other formula can remove. We have so much fear that we're finding every possible way to do everything else. Again, I'm saying we understand the medical precautions and they should be taken. Yes, we should listen to what the governments are saying of our countries, etc. Because when they say certain things, we live in their countries. We have to follow them to the best of our ability. Okay? And we have to assist in times like this to curb this. But is closing the masjid assisting to curb it? Is it going to assist? Then in that case, close everything else. Close everything else. We should not lose trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have we forgotten the basic that no illness can spread without the will of Allah, and that Allah who can cause you to become ill in a gathering of a million, if He wills, He can cause you to be afflicted by the virus in the privacy of your bedroom. The same Allah who can cause you, who you think will end up making you sick inside the masjid, can He not make you sick inside in your bedroom while you're sitting alone hiding from the entire dunya? If Allah wills for you to get bimar, you will beg bimar. You cannot stop it. Take the precautions. But everything is upon the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, masjids are closed. Around the world, there are places where mazars have been locked and shuttered. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. The atheists are laughing. The atheists are mocking. They are saying Muslims are so scared that they close their mosques. So where is their God? They are using the word God. Where is their God? But mazhabs are saying Sunnis go to awliya when in need. Whenever they got any problem, they go into the awliya, they go into Khaja, they go into Ghospak. How come now they're locking all these places? How come now they're closing all the places? My beloveds, it is our akidah that the awliya are our helpers. That is why we say Ghos ya azam bamane besaru sama madade. Qibla e deen madade kabe o ima madade. And when do we need more help than when we are in a calamity? That is when we need to go to the darbar and beg for the blessings and ask them to make dua for us. Allahu Akbar, have we forgotten that these awliya Allah are our protectors by the hukum of Allah? We are the Ahle Sunnah. We are those who say, Ya Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We are those who say, Ya Ali Mushkil Kusha. We say, Ya Al-Madad Ya Khaja. We are the ones who say, Ya Rasulullah, naho aram jis bimar ko sare zamane se utha le aaye thori khaak unke aastane se. میرے عزیزو، اگر خواجہ کی چوکٹ کو بند کر دے گے، اگر خواجہ کی چوکٹ کو بند کر دے گے تو بھکاری اور غریب کہاں جائے گے؟ ہے بغداد میں جنگ چل رہا ہے، گولیاں چل رہی ہے، بارودیں گر رہی ہے، اور غوث پاک کا فیض جاری ہے، اس وقت بھی آج بھی جاری ہے. Where is our trust in Allah? Where is our yakin in those whom Allah has put for our protection? I'm asking, when the announcement was made on Sunday, I'm talking about our country again. When the announcement was made on Sunday, and it was said that more than 100 people can't get together, understandable, and I'm saying we accept the rule that has been made and we should try our best to follow. We should make our best effort. Okay? How many, after this announcement on Sunday, how many places had Kirpuri Niyaz on Monday in the masajid? I want to ask, how many masajid were there that had the Niyaz of Imam Jafar Sadiq? How many people came there? Whether they came to collect, whether they came to eat, how many people came there? How many people who came to take Niyaz or have Niyaz got this virus or spread this virus? Inshallah, none. All of them who came got saved because of Hazrat Imam Jafar Sadiq radiallahu ta'ala. They got saved. No, today we want to close the masjid. Sallu fi buyutikum, as-salatu fi buyutikum. Actually, sallu fi rihalikum. And then when this hukum was given in Zamana Rasul and after, what was the reason? For how many days was this command given? Was it for days, weeks and months, or only for one time namaz? Look at it and look at the reasons behind all these things. Huh? This coronavirus is a waba, it's a pandemic, it's a bimari, but it's not yakini. It's not something that is yakini that definitely all these people will die with it. Definitely all these people will get infected. Take the precautions. But it is not a valid reason to voluntarily close down the house of Allah. Yes, if there is a lockdown, we have no power. We can't do anything. We can't move out of our own homes. But when you are being given the flexibility, this is Allah's rahmat. It is Allah's rahmat that we can go and open our masajid. It is Allah's fazal on us. Everything else is based on assumption today. How many will die? Where they will die? My beloveds, that is already ordained. Imam Asyuti radiallahu anhu says in Sharh al-Sudur that Ibn Salim reports that Ibrahim alayhi salam asked Malak al-Maut, in the time of plague, someone is in the east and someone is in the west, what do you do in the situation? He said, I summon the souls by the command of Allah and they come to me between these fingers of mine. He summons them, whether you are in the masjid or whether you are in the market or whether you are in your bedroom. When he summons the souls at a time like this, they will go. From wherever they may be. And he said, the earth has been made like a tray unto me, so I pick from where I wish. He further says that Malak al-Maut was asked about how he removes the soul, Imam Suyuti says. And he said, I summon them and they come to me saying, Labbaik. Huh? Think about this. Maut ka itna dar hai. Theek hai, we fear that we are so scared of death. But do you not fear Allah who gave life and death? Huh? People are saying, it doesn't mean if we close the masjid, we don't fear Allah. I'm not saying you don't. But I'm saying it's not the thing to do right now because we have the flexibility. The reason that we have this flexibility is Allah's mercy upon us. Huh? Is Allah's mercy upon us. Hazrat Dawood ibn Hind reported a narration where he mentions, I was afflicted by plague and due to this I became unconscious. When I regained consciousness, two angels appeared to me. One said to the other, what do you sense? He said, Tasbih. The angel said, Tasbih, Takbir, walking towards the masjid in some recitation of the Quran. Go and see, Imam Asyuti radiallahu anhu has quoted it. My beloveds, we should be going to the masjid in a time like this and making dua for safety of our communities, for the safety of our country. We should be opening our masjid and saying, let's pray Khatme Qadriya now. Let's pray Khatme Khajagan. This is what you need. Not cancelling our means of safety and security. Not cancelling our nights to honor the salah. Here, instead of honoring the night that our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam went into the heights of the heavens and brought salah, we are closing the masjid in which the people come to read salah and to gain the blessings of Mi'raj al-Mu'mineen. Huh? You got people saying all different types of things. All different types of things. Look at what is in the hadith. Look, go back to the hadith. Muslim Sharif hadith, Osama bin Zayd radiallahu anhu said, plague is the sign of punishment. It is azab. Allah caused some people from his servants to be afflicted by it. So when you hear about it occurring somewhere, do not enter there, and when it breaks out in the land where you are present, then do not run away, do not flee from it. But at the same time, what does he say? Imam Ahmad and Bukhari have reported the authority of Aisha radiallahu anha, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa said, plague was a punishment which Allah sends against whomsoever he wills. Allah has made it a mercy for the believers. One who remains steadfast and patient in a land infected by plague, hoping for reward and knowing that only that which Allah has written for him will befall him, then he shall attain the reward equivalent to that of a martyr. Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, Imam Ahmad have reported on the authority of Sayyidatuna Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu anha that Rasulullah said death from plague. Death from plague for every Muslim is what? It's shahada. It's shahada. But what we are saying, close the masjid. People are saying, no, they are telling the communities. But look, in Saudi they have closed the masjids. In Yemen they have closed the masjid. Are they the example for us? Are they the examples? Are those who stop you from saying As-salatu wa-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah examples? Are those who tell you it is bidat and shirk from asking from Rasulullah Pak your examples? What is this? We should be going towards the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at Jami' Sahih. Look at Jami' Kabir. Look at what Imam Suyuti says. He says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said when Allah wants to afflict any nation with some calamity, he looks at those who had the masjids and then he grants respite because of them. He grants respite because of them. What I'm trying to say, this is what's in my heart. And I know those who dislike what I'm saying will dislike, but I have to say this. My beloveds, by closing the masajid without reason, without such a valid reason, we are still being allowed the flexibility. By closing the masjid while you have this flexibility, you are putting yourselves and the ummah in the eye of the storm. You are putting ourselves in the eye of the storm and it will erode our lives and our akhirat. Do not put yourself in the eye of the storm. The masjid will remove us from the eye of the storm. Will we not die one day? Will we not die, whether we die from the virus or from something else? Allahu Akbar, I go back to what Sarkar Tajul Sharia said. I'm going back to what Huzur Tajul Sharia said. And I'm going to end this is not, it's not a lecture. I've not delivered, I will not be delivering, this is before Jummah I'm saying all of these things. Okay? And I'm going to share this with you whenever I can. But I'm not saying that because at the masjid we have short process today and we are doing this based on trying to follow the rule that has been set. But at the same time, we are still trying to do Jummah within the flexible conditions that have been given to us. Okay? But whatever I'm saying, it's honestly not a taqreer, it's what I'm feeling. It's the dard, and I think my pain is shared not only by myself but by many ulama. And by you, the public at large all over the world is feeling this dard and this taqleef of what is happening. More than what the virus is causing the taklif and the dard to us, this is hurting our hearts that the house of Allah is being closed. What is this life all about? My Murshid Huzur Sayyidi Taj Sharia radiallahu an, what does he say? He says, Zindagi ye nahi hai kisi ke liye, Zindagi hai nabi ke liye, na samaj marte hai zindagi ke liye, jina marna hai sab kuch nabi ke liye. And what is he saying? He says, if you worry that you have some bala and some calamity that's gonna overwhelm you, he says, think, tujhe kya fikr ho akhtar, tere yaver hai wo yaver. Tujhe kya fikr ho akhtar, tere yaver hai wo yaver. Balao ko jo teri khud giriftare bala kar de. Balao ko jo meri khud giriftare bala kar de. Leave those calamities that are coming. Our Nabi will put them into calamity by themselves. Destroy them. In other words, the Nabi will cause them to be destroyed. Have yakin in Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Have yakin in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've said this many times in addressing, trying to share what I feel with you. I'm not saying go against the rules. I'm not saying break the precautions. No, we shouldn't. But at the same time, attempt to the best of your ability to follow what Allah and His Rasul have commanded, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why is it that when we're being allowed to do some things, we don't want to do it, but we want to do everything else? Think about it for a moment, and think about one thing: whether it's you or I, ek din aankhe band hogi. One day our eyes will close. I'm not saying that if you go to the masjid, you won't get an infection and you won't die. Nobody can guarantee that, but nobody can guarantee you're going to die also. But I have hope that those who go in the court of Allah, Allah will protect them. And because of them, Allah will protect others in this country and everywhere else. I have get yakin from my Rabb, without doubt. Allah keep us with iman. Allah let us live with iman. Allah protect the Muslim ummah from this calamity. Allah protect the entire world from this calamity. Allah protect us all the countries that are going through all this. Allah protect everybody's lives from this waba and from this pandemic that is there. My request to all of you, like the great mashayikh and the ulama and all the organizations have been telling you since day one, read Ayatul Kursi. Read the three kuls every day. Read بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. Read, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات كلها من شر ما خلق. Read all these blessed du'as. الحمد لله الذي عافاني مما ابتلاك به وفضلني على كثير ممن خلق تفضيلا. Read, يا لطيف لم يزل لطف بنا فيما نزل. أنت قوي نجنا عن كهرك يوم الخلل. لي خمسة عطفي بها هر الوباء الحاتمة المصطفى والمرتضى وابناهما والفاطمة. إن شاء الله through the barakat of Panjatan Park we will be safe. Through the barakat of Panjatan Park we will be safe. مگر امام حسین رضی اللہ عنہ نے تو اپنے سر کو سجدے میں کٹا دیا تھا. Hey, on the plains of Karbala امام حسین gave his head in سجدہ. ہم لوگ مسجدوں کو چھوڑ رہے. سیکھو ذرا Panjatan Park سے. Learn from those who taught us how to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands. And inshallah, in their sadqa will be saved. Warna hame bachne, koi dawa hame bachane wali nahi hai. No medicines can save you. That is only a zariya. Allah is the one who will save. And how He will save you? Through your yaqeen in your beloveds. Through your yaqeen in those who you have iman and aqeedah on, that by Allah's hukum and by Allah's ata, they are your madadgar in this dunya. They are your madadgar in the qabr. And